separateness. We might, in fact, be a little bit separate because our situation is different. But then we elevate that, and so that fear can really, really elevate our personal feelings of alienation and disenfranchisement, etc. Mm-hmm. So that's an example of an irrational fear, and it can feel like such a huge wall that we can't figure out how to get over that wall. And we've all experienced one or more situations in our life where when we hear somebody else's perspective, that fear, all of a sudden, that wall shrinks. It's not nearly as big. Mm-hmm. What's the definition of success? What a great question. And we could devote seminary semesters to that. For me, for those of us who remember that television show decades ago, Name That Tune, mm-hmm. where somebody would claim, oh, I can name that tune in 5 notes. Oh, okay, I can name it in 4 notes. Right. Well, I'd like to say I can take the 66 books of the Bible, the Old and New Testament, I can name that tune in 2 words. Mm-hmm. I would propose that starting in the garden, all the way through Jesus being here for 36 months and Revelation, those 2 words would be, follow me. Jesus didn't give the 12 disciples a list of 500 things they had to master by the time he left. No, every day he just said, follow me, follow mm-hmm. me. And how spectacularly freeing that I don't have to have everything right every day. I don't have to memorize this list, and I don't have to be a theological guru and an apologetic kingpin. No, I just need to follow the master. I don't know whether he's going to turn left or turn right or stop or whatever. All I have to do is follow him. And Willow Creek, a leader of tens of thousands of churches here in America, did a study recently on what is it that contributes to spiritual growth, spiritual development. And they said they've been doing it wrong for all these years. They mm-hmm. said that which contributes to spiritual development is not so much classes in the church. It's the spiritual disciplines. It's spending time mm-hmm. with the Lord, time in the Word, time in prayer, meditating, solitude, etc. And it's as I spend time sitting in my closet or under a tree, that's when I can sense, okay, is Jesus off to the left? Is he off to the right? Is he straight ahead? Is he telling me to stop? All I have to do is find out where he is and then follow him. Mm-hmm. So the temptation is to have to read all the books and have all the answers. Yeah. And not to say that's not important.
Right.
But what is success? Success is successfully following the master, turning left when he turns left, turning right when he turns right. So that would be my primary suggestion. We need to spend time with him to understand his heart, and thereby we can hear his invitation, which direction he's calling us in situations, at decision points in life, etc. That's success.
Amen, brother. I'm right there with you. I love, and so when we apply this, what you just said, to parenting, if our heart's desire is to help our children to be successful, then we need to disciple them in this. We need to help them to know the voice of their God, of Jesus, their shepherd. We need to help them to study the Word. We have to teach them how to study the Word. We have to teach them how to pray. We have to, all these things. But how can we teach them? Well, only if we know how to do it ourselves. We first have to be a disciple of Christ. And in 2 Timothy, it talks about, or actually, no, 2 Thessalonians, it talks about how Paul dealt with the people of the church in that area. And he said that he dealt with them like a mother to their children, you know, nurturing, and like a father, encouraging. And that when we invite the body of Christ and these disciplers, you know, into our lives, we are parenting. And so our first, you know, a lot of times we think of discipling as something you do with church members. We first disciple our children in this, you know? And so when we become that disciple, we can be the example to our children. And like you said, it is through studying the Word of God that we're able to do that. It's that living Word of God.
You know, we have the option. In fact, we are, we're invited by the world 23 and a half hours a day to raise our children the same way our unbelieving neighbors do, exactly mm-hmm. the same way, expose them to the same television, the same everything. So we're all well trained in the world system of parenting. Mm-hmm. And in order to avoid that, in order to prevent our children turning out like children of unbelievers, we need to be thoroughly devoted to the Master and teach our children to look to Him as well. And they'll hear that His different call, His different voice, which will be distinct from the call of the world.
Yes.
And then discipleship, if you and I submit ourselves to personal discipleship, that is, if we have a mentor or mentors in our life, they're causing us to take a perspective, a look at our lives that we wouldn't on our own.
Right.
So we as parents, I think it's so thoroughly biblical, we hardly need to mention it, but
right.
We parents can benefit dramatically from a disciple-making relationship if we have a mentor working mm-hmm. in our lives, and then we can mentor our children and even invite, especially a fatherless child, mm-hmm. To be exposed to men in the community
yes.
who will adopt
yes.
that young boy or that daughter
right.
so he or she can be exposed to a father, even if it's not a biological father or a father mm-hmm. by marriage.
Absolutely, I totally agree with you. And isn't it good news that the Word of God will cause the change? When we digest this Word of God, when we spend time studying it, we don't have to be afraid that that children are going to turn out whatever, because the Word of God says, and I'm just going to read it because it says so much better, and then we'll close. As the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return to it without watering the earth and making it bud and flourish, so that it yields a seed for the sower and bread for the eater, so my word that goes out from my mouth will not return to me empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it. I want to thank everyone so much for joining us, and I want to thank you for being our guest here today. I've learned so much from you, and remember that you are not alone. I'm Jennifer Dow with The Single Parent. Thank you.